بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. والحمد لله رب العالمين، بارئ الخلائق أجمعين، باعث الأنبياء والمرسلين، ثم الصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء وسيد المرسلين، حبيب إله العالمين، المصطفى بالقاسم محمد، اللهم صل على محمد وعلى محمد، وعلى آله الطيبين الطاهرين المعصومين المنتجبين الذين أذهب الله عنهم الرجس وطهرهم تطهيرا. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آله. ولعنة الله على أعدائهم أجمعين إلى قيام يوم الدين. السلام عليك يا مولاي يا أبا عبد الله، السلام عليك يا ابن رسول الله، السلام عليك يا غريب كربلاء، رزقنا الله في الدنيا زيارتكم وشفاعتكم في الدنيا والآخرة. أما بعد، فقد قال الله تبارك وتعالى في كتابه المجيد وقرآنه الحميد وقوله الحق: أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الله يحب المحسنين. صدق الله العلي العظيم. صلى على محمد وآل محمد. صلى على محمد وآل محمد. Over the next three nights, we will be dedicating those nights for Amir al-Mu'mineen salawatullahi wa salamuhu alayhi. And in the English lectures, inshallah, our discussion will be about nine attributes that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in the Quran that He loves. We will discuss three attributes every night, if Allah gives us tawfiq, where we will show, inshallah, how each one of those attributes relate to Amirul Mu'mineen salawatullahi wa salamuhu alayhi, with the exception of the last one. I will briefly mention the nine attributes, inshallah. But again, we will be discussing the first three tonight if Allah gives us tawfiq, the next three tomorrow night, inshallah, and then the last three the following night. When we take a look at the Quran, several times Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Inna Allah yuhibbu, Allah surely loves, and then so on so. So a group of individuals who carry certain attributes, certain characteristics. Or Wallahu yuhibbu, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves. So if we look at those ayat and we combine the duplicates, because some of them have repetitions, they come more than once. If we look at them, we can see that they fall under nine categories. What are these nine categories? One, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves the muttaqeen. Allah yuhibbu al-muttaqeen. This part of the ayah appears several times in the Quran. So Allah loves those who are God conscious. Muttaqeen. That's one. Second, Inna Allah yuhibbu al-muhsineen. Allah loves those who are kind, good doers. That's two. Three, Inna Allah yuhibbu al-muqsitin. Allah loves those who are just. Muqsit means they are fair, they're just. So that's the third category. Four, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in Surah As-Saff, Inna Allah يحب الذين يقاتلون في سبيله صفا كأنهم بنيان مرصوص. Allah loves those who fight in his path as if they are firm wall, a firm building. They're all together. Allah loves those people who fight in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's number four. Five. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُتَوَكِّلِينَ. Allah loves those who rely upon him. And we'll discuss what that means by relying upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. التوكل على الله عز وجل. Then, number six. وَاللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الصَّابِرِينَ. Allah loves those who are patient. Number seven. وَاللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الْمُطَّهِّرِينَ. Allah loves those who are purified, those who purify themselves. Eight. Here there is a repetition. Oh, sorry. Number eight. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Ali Imran, قُلْ يعني say, يا رسول الله, إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهِ, if you love Allah, فَاتَّبِعُونِي, follow me, يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهِ, Allah will love you back, وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ. Here there is an addition which is unique. Allah not only says he loves those who will follow you, ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, he says you tell them, if you love Allah, follow me, Allah will love you, and there is a bonus, وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ, and he will forgive your sins. So there's a bonus about following Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. And that will be on the third night, inshallah, when we will discuss this. And the last one, which really does not apply to Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam, although he gives us the guidance towards it. Allah says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ التَّوَّابِينَ. Allah loves those who repent, constantly repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the same ayah, there is a repetition. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ التَّوَّابِينَ وَيُحِبُّ الْمُتَطَهِّرِينَ. And he loves those who purify themselves again. And the other ayah was يُحِبُّ الْمُتَطَهِّرِينَ. Here, مُتَطَهِّرِينَ. We'll discuss that, inshallah. التوابين, أمير المؤمنين سلام الله عليه, never left the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala so that he would come back to it again. You and I need to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He never. However, he teaches us, salamullahi alayhi, how to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He guides us how to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that last one, number nine, may not apply to Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam directly, but he is the guide for us how to do so and how to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So these are nine attributes that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions at various times in the Quran that he loves about certain of his creation. Tonight, if Allah gives us tawfiq, we'll take a look at the first three, inshallah. And we'll show how those three relate to Amir al-Mu'mineen salawatullahi wa salamuhu alayhi. The first one, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُتَّقِينَ. Allah loves those who are God conscious. Have taqwa Allah, piety. The second, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. Allah loves those who are good doers. And the third, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُقْسِطِينَ. Allah loves those who are just. How do those three apply to Amir al-Mu'mineen salawatullahi wa salamuhu alayhi? Well, the first one, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُتَّقِينَ. Or, وَاللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الْمُتَّقِينَ. Just for those of you who would like to have, you know, to note down sometimes, this part of the ayah appears several times. Amongst them, Ali Imran, verse 76. فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُتَّقِينَ. Another one, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in Surah At-Tawbah, ayah number 4. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُتَّقِينَ. That's the second time. Third time, Surah At-Tawbah, ayah number 7. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُتَّقِينَ. Again, Allah repeats it. Again, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions it in other ayat of the Quran, but these will suffice. These are just three examples where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions that He loves those who are God conscious. Muttaqeen, taqwa, as I mentioned a few nights ago, I'll briefly mention it. Taqwa has several meanings. The simplest of the meanings is when a person performs and does everything that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala orders and refrains, stops, keeps away from everything that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forbid. That is a muttaqi. That's a muttaqi. Taqwa is a higher level than iman. We have Islam, that's the first level. Someone who becomes a Muslim. In Surah Al-Hujurat, Allah says, قَالَتِ الْأَعْرَابُ آمَنَّا قُلْ لَمْ تُؤْمِنُوا وَلَكِنْ قُولُوا أَسْلَمْنَا وَلَمَّا يَدْخُلِ الْإِيمَانُ فِي قُلُوبِكُمْ. Some of the Arabs used to come to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, they say the shahada, and they say, we are now mu'mineen. The ayah came to say, no, you've just became Muslims. Islam is the words, the shahada. The minute anyone says the shahadatain, khalas, he's a Muslim. That's it. Now, once he says them, then he has to perform certain obligations and duties. For example, salat, siyam, hajj, zakat, and so on and so forth. When he or she starts performing them, he's now a mu'min. So that's a level. And that's why there is a narration attributed to Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam, where he says, al-Islamu daraja. Islam is one step getting closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then, wal-imanu daraja. Iman is a higher step. A mu'min is greater than a Muslim. He's doing deeds and rituals. In the Quran, interestingly, whenever Allah mentions those who believe, He couples it with al-amal al-salih. الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ طُوبَى لَهُمْ وَحُسْنُ مَآبٍ. Those who believe and do good deeds. Meaning, belief alone is not enough. Someone says, خلاص, I believe and that's it. The belief is in the heart. We say this contradicts the Quran. Quran says, believe and عَمَلُوا الصَّالِحِ. So one has to perform good deeds. Once a person starts performing these good deeds, and refraining from the sins, whatever Allah says is haram, he stays away from it. This person now has developed a level of taqwa, God consciousness. Then, the next level of taqwa is when he starts doing all these deeds purely for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Just like we read in Surah Al-Insan, إِنَّمَا نُطْعِمُكُمْ لِوَجْهِ اللَّهِ لَا نُرِيدُ مِنْكُمْ جَزَاءً وَلَا شُكُورًا. We feed you for the sake of Allah, the pleasure of Allah. We don't want a thank you from you, nor a reward. Purely for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's the third level, taqwa. So we have the first level is Islam, second is Iman, third is Taqwa, which is now a higher level. And that's why when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions the Muttaqeen or Taqwa, He does not couple it with Amal al-Salih. وَسَارِعُوا إِلَىٰ مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ وَجَنَّةٍ عَرْضُهَا السَّمَاوَاتُ وَالْأَرْضُ أُعِدَّتْ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. خلاص, متقين. Rush, Allah says rush. In dunya, we rush for materialistic things. If you hear there is a sale somewhere, people rush. Sometimes they line up because they might save a little bit of money. In dunya, we rush for materialistic things. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, these materialistic things don't really have much value. وَسَارِعُوا إِلَىٰ مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ. Rush to a forgiveness of your Lord. Yani when it comes to doing good deeds, that's what you should rush for. Laylatul Qadr, tonight, rush. Don't delay. Do the a'mal. Allah says, وَاسْتَبِقُوا الْخَيْرَاتِ. When it comes to doing good deeds, have a competition. Sibaq. استَبِقُوا. We rush in dunya for worldly matters. Allah says, no, خَيْرَاتِ. Good deeds, that's what you should rush for. إن للمتقين مفازا حدائق وأعنابا وكواعب أترابا وكأسا دهاقا. متقين will have all these blessings in Jannah as per the آيات in سورة النبأ that inshallah later on we inshallah will get the chance to discuss when we discuss سورة النبأ inshallah. So متقين, Allah does not say تقوى and عمل الصالح because they're already at a higher level than this. And then the last one, he says يقين واليقين درجة, certainty. And even يقين has ranks. عين اليقين, حق اليقين. There are different kinds of يقين. ألهاكم التكاثر حتى زرتم المقابر كلا سوف تعلمون ثم كلا سوف تعلمون كلا لو تعلمون علم اليقين. That's the first one. لترون الجحيم ثم لترونها عين اليقين. That's a higher level. And then in Surah Al-Waqi'ah, Allah says حق اليقين. That's the highest rank of yaqeen. Even yaqeen has ranks. So a muttaqi is someone who devotes himself for the pleasure of Allah. And therefore it varies. Imam Ali salamullah alayhi is Imam al-Muttaqeen. He's the master, the commander. You want to look at taqwa Allah, look at Ali ibn Abi Talib salamullah alayhi. Allah out of his rahmah, when he gave us these examples in the Quran about muttaqin, muhsinin, muqsitin, he gave us examples that we can follow, role models. And Imam Ali ibn Abi Talib salamullah alayhi, after Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, is the best role model. One of the companions of the Prophet by the name of Abu Darda, he says, we were sitting down in the masjid of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, and some people were discussing about those who fought with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi in the battle of Badr, and those who pledged Bay'at al-Radwan, you know, the pledge at the place called Radwan, those mu'mineen and so on and so forth. He said to them, people, do you want me to tell you who is the least in his money, but the greatest in his God consciousness and obedience to Allah? They said, who? He said, Ali ibn Abi Talib, salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi. They said, Ya Abu Darda, no, there was a dispute. People were disputing that, no, it's not Ali ibn Abi Talib. So Abu Darda said, you guys say whatever you want to say. Here is what I have seen and observed. One night I was walking on the outskirts of Medina at night, and I heard a voice in the middle of the night worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the middle of the night. That voice was saying, Ilahi, كَمَّمُّ بِقَةٍ حَلُمْتَ عَنْ مُقَابَلَتِهَا بِنَقِمَتِكَ وَكَمْ مِنْ جَرِيرَةٍ تَكَرَّمْتَ عَنْ كَشْفِهَا بِكَرَمِكَ إِلَهِ إِنْ طَالَ فِي عِصْيَانِكَ عُمُرِي وَعَظُمَ فِي الصُّحُفِ ذَنْبِي فَمَا أَنَا مُؤَمِّلٌ غَيْرْ غُفْرَانَكَ وَلَا أَنَا بِرَاجٍ غَيْرِ رِضْوَانَكَ. He says, O Allah, my sins have accumulated on my back, and I am seeking your forgiveness, Ya Allah. Here, of course, Amir al-Mu'mineen, Salamullahi alayhi, according to the Shi'i belief, he is pure, he is sinless, he is ma'soom. So why would the Imam, and not only him, other Imams alayhim as-salam, say, Ya Allah, forgive our sins? Like we read in Dua Kumail, أَتَيْتُكَ يَا إِلَهِي بَعْدَ تَقْصِيرِي وَإِسْرَافِي عَلَى نَفْسِي مُعْتَذِرًا نَادِمًا مُنْكَسِرًا مُسْتَقِيلًا مُسْتَغْفِرًا مُنِيبًا. He says, I've come to you, Ya Allah, seeking repentance. Why would Imam Ali ibn Abi Talib alayhi as-salam seek repentance? Here, the ulama have some opinions. First, he's teaching us He's teaching us how to do istighfar. Because one of the important roles of the imam that we discussed a few nights ago is hidayah, to guide. وَجَعَلْنَاهُمْ أَئِمَّةً يَهْدُونَ بِأَمْرِنَا. We made them imams who guide through our commands. They guide. So he's guiding us. He's teaching us how to do istighfar. And if I want to ask Allah for forgiveness, how do I do it? Imam Ali alayhi salam and the imam say, here, read Dua al-Tawbah by Imam al-Sajjad alayhi salam. This is how you seek repentance. Read Dua Kumail. This is how you seek repentance. There you go. So they're teaching us how to do it. That's one opinion. Another opinion, we have a riwayah, a narration, where the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam says, Ana wa Ali abawa hadhihi al-ummah. Ali and I are like the fathers of this nation. Sometimes when your son, God forbid, let's say you have a son, and one day he takes a rock and he throws it at the neighbor's window and breaks it. And then he comes home. And he tells you, Dad, I broke the window of our neighbors. Some parents, what would they do? They will take the hand of their son. They go, they knock on the door of the neighbor. And he would say to the neighbor, I want to apologize. I am sorry. Why? My son broke the window. Well, why are you apologizing? Have you done that, or have you gone experienced something similar? Where your son or daughter may do something, you go and apologize. Why? You didn't do anything wrong. But because that son is of you, whatever he or she, the daughter, does, reflects on you. And therefore, when they do something wrong, you apologize. You say, I'm sorry. Please forgive me. We are like the children of Ali ibn Abi Talib alayhi salam. And we sin. He is like that merciful father who says, Ilahi, I have come to you. Yani, I will take that burden. I apologize to you for what my followers, the ummah, has done. Just like a father who would apologize about the mistake of his child, for example. So that's the second opinion. Third opinion, Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam, because of their belief in Allah. When it is that they have to sleep, because they're human beings at the end of the day, so he has to sleep a little bit. He sleeps, even his sleep is ibadah. But he feels, even this half an hour a day that he sleeps, Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam did not sleep much. Even this half an hour, he feels that he's at shortcoming. Yani he needs to spend 24 hours in the day in worshiping Allah. When he doesn't, he feels that he is at a shortcoming. Although he's not, but that's how he feels. Because he loves Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And hence, that's how he asks for forgiveness. So these are three opinions as to why imams alayhim as-salam ask Allah for forgiveness. Now, Abu Darda, going back to our story, he sees Amir al-Mu'mineen praying in the middle of the night, asking Allah for forgiveness. He says, I approached and I saw it was Ali ibn Abi Talib salamullah alayhi, in the middle of the night, on the outskirts of Medina, putting his head on the sand in the desert and crying and asking Allah for forgiveness. Until I did not hear any noise from him anymore. I came to him. I shook him. كان كالخشبة. He was like a piece of a log, wood. I said, إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. مَاتَ عَلِي. Ali has died. So I went back to Medina. I knocked on the door of Fatima salamullahi alayha. She said, who is it? I said, I am Abu Darda, ya binta Rasulillah. I have some bad news. I have some sad news. What? I just came from the outskirts of Medina and Ali has died. She said, what did you see him? How? Why do you say he's dead? He said, this is what happened. He was worshipping Allah and then he went into a deep silence. I came, I tried to move him. shake him, he would not respond. She said, يا أبا الدرداء تلك الغشية التي تعتريه من خشية الله عز وجل. يا أبا الدرداء, he's not dead. This is what happens to Ali ibn Abi Talib عليه السلام when he remembers Allah and he prays to Allah out of the fear of Allah. She says, take some water, splash it on his face, and he will wake up. He said, I couldn't believe her. I moved him. He was dead. So he said, I took some of the water and I went and I splashed some water on his face. And indeed, he woke up. So I looked at him. I said, Ya Ali, why do you do this to yourself? He said, Ya Abu Darda, who will save me on the day of judgment when we stand before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? So that is Amir al-Mu'mineen, Imam al-Muttaqeen, Ali ibn Abi Talib, salawatullahi alayhi. This is one of the examples, one of the beautiful examples about how he is the master of the Muttaqeen. Then, the second one, Allah says, Allah loves those who are muhsineen, those who are kind, virtuous, good doers. Amir al-Mu'mineen, salamullah alayh, again, after Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, is at the top of the list. He would help the poor, he would help the needy, he would give even to his enemies. Even his enemies. When he became the Khalifa, salamullah alayh, by Khilafah, we mean Khilafah al-Zahiriyya, Khilafah al-Dunya. At some point in his Khilafah, the Khawarij, the Kharijites, turned against him. And they started calling him names. They started calling him Kafir, wal'iyadu billah. And he is the Khalifa, he is the head of the state. So people used to tell him, Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, you should punish them. He said, since they have not transgressed against anyone else, and they're just calling me names, then khalas, this is their right. Today, people say freedom of speech. Amir al-Mu'mineen, salamullah alayhi, implemented this back in those days, 1400 years ago. In the masjid, he is giving a khutbah in Masjid al-Kufa, and he's the Khalifa of the Muslims. One of the Khawarij listens to Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam, and then he gets up in shock and says, Kafirun ma afqaha. He's a kafir, but he is so knowledgeable. So the companions wanted to jump on him and kill him. He immediately stopped them. He said, stop. إِنَّهُ إِمَّا سَبٌّ بِسَبْ أَوْ عَفْوٌ عَنْ ذَنْبْ وَأَنَا عَفَوْتُ عَنْ. It's either he insults me and I insult him back, or we forgive and I choose to forgive him. خلاص, leave him. SubhanAllah, where do we see such rulers in the world and such leaders in the world? Not too often, not too often, with that kind of personality. Muhsin, salamullahi alayhi, he is the master of muhsineen. He used to give, salamullahi alayhi, for the pleasure of Allah and for the sake of Allah. And then the third one, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُقَسِطِينَ. Allah loves those who are just, they are fair. And again, Amir al-Mu'mineen, salamullah alayhi, is the master of justice, salamullah alayhi, after Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. In one of the battles, he loses his armor, or his shield. Then one day he was walking on the streets of Kufa, he finds a man who was not a Muslim, and he is selling this shield of his, salamullahi alayhi. Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam comes to him and says, that's mine. He said, no, it's not. He said, but it's mine. He said, no, we can go to the judge. So they go to judge, Shuraih al-Qadi. When they enter before the judge looks at Imam Amir al-Mu'mini alayhi salam and he says, Assalamu alayka ya Aba al-Hasan. Amir al-Mu'mini alayhi salam says, you have not done justice. He said, why? He said, when I entered, you called me by my kunya, Abu al-Hasan. Now this person will think, oh, the judge knows Ali ibn Abi Talib. So there is connection here. So, since he has a connection, then maybe he might favor him over me. So he says, make sure that when you see people and you greet them, don't call them by their names. This way, it becomes more fair. He says, okay, what's the matter? Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam says to this man that he has my shield. This is my shield. The man says, no, it's mine. Shuraih turns to Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam and says, هل لك من بينة? Do you have a proof? Because the shield was in the hands of this man. صاحب اليد. We have a law in Islam. Someone who has something under his possession, if that possession is disputed, he does not have to present evidence to show that it is his. The one who's disputing must present the evidence. And for example, somebody's wearing a jacket right now. If you're wearing a jacket, someone comes and says, this is my jacket. Before the judge, you would tell them, you bring in the evidence that this is your jacket. You yourself don't have to bring in any evidence because you're wearing it. Mean it's under your possession, it's under your control. صاحب اليد. So, the one who has the possession does not need to bring in any evidence. البينة على من ادعى. The one who is questioning you, debating against you, he has to bring in the evidence. And that's why it's interesting here. When Sayyidah Zahra alayhi salam came to ask for Fadak, Fadak was under her possession. It was taken away from her. Yet, the first Khalifa asked her to bring the evidence and proof to show that it is hers. When in fact, he should have brought the proof. So that's where we see evidence of the change of the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, right after his death, salamullahi alayhi. Anyways, Amir al-Mu'mineen said to Shuraih, I don't have evidence. Shuraih said, then khalas, if you don't have evidence, then the shield stays with the man, it's his. Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam looks at Shuraih and says, well done, ahsant, good job. And they leave. They go outside of the courthouse. This man looks at Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam. He says, أَوَلَسْتَ عَلِيَّ ابْنَ أَبِي طَالِبِ Aren't you عَلِيُّ ابْنَ أَبِي طَالِبِ And the man started having doubts a little bit. He said, yes. He says, didn't you appoint this judge as a judge? He said, yes. He said, you're the Khalifa of the Muslims? He said, yes. He said, but the judge just ruled against you. He said, that's حُكْمُ اللَّهِ That's the law. He judged by Allah's sunnah, the sunnah to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, hukm Allah azza wa jal. I don't have proof. You had the shield under your control and your possession. I'm the one challenging you. I don't have evidence. It stays with you. قال أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأن محمد رسول الله وأنك خليفة رسول الله بالحق. الله صلى الله عليه وسلم.
محمد وآل محمد.
He says, which man, which leader would do something like this? I've never seen something like this unless you are really the successor of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. He says, you've just proved it to me. And he says, ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, this is your shield back. Take it. It's yours. This was the one example of the justice of Amir al-Mu'mineen salamullahi alayhi. One example out of so many. صلى الإله على جسد تضمنه قبر فصار فيه العدل مدفونا قد حالف العدل لم يضاغن به حتى صار بالإيمان والعدل مقرونا. Says one of the followers of Amir al-Mu'mineen sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, these lines of poetry, Suda bint Himar al-Hamdaniya. She said that justice was buried with Ali ibn Abi Talib alayhi salam. Justice. She referred to him as justice. Adala. هو العدل صلوات الله وسلامه عليه. And hence, many times he would say, when would Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala send the worst of his creation to die this from this? Meaning to strike me on my head and the blood would cover my beard. Because towards the end of his life, salamullah alayhi, he was tired. He was in a lot of pain. He turns to some of his companions and says, لَقَدْ مَلَأْتُمْ قَلْبِي قَيْحًا يَا أَشْبَاهَ الرِّجَالِ وَلَسْتُمْ بِرِجَالِ. He says to the people, you really have filled my heart with agony and pain. So he was in pain, salamullah alayhi. And then he sees some of his beloved people leaving this dunya, one after the other. One day he stands on the pulpit and he cries, سلام الله عليه. قال أين عمار؟ أين ابن التيهان؟ أين ذو الشهادتين؟ Where is عمار؟ ابن التيهان، ذو الشهادتين. Those dear companions of mine, they got killed in صفين. He lost them, سلام الله عليه. He says, where are they? يا أيها الموت الذي لست بتاركي أرحني فقد أفنيت كل خليلي أراك بصيرا بالذين أحبهم وكأنك تسعى نحوهم بدليلي. He says, death, come and get me because I'm tired. Those whom I love, you are targeting them one after the other. So, سلام الله عليه. He would look then at عبد الرحمن بن ملجم and he would tell his companions, هذا قاتلي. This is the man who will kill me. He is the Khalifa of the Muslims. They say, Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, if that is the case, why don't you then capture him and kill him? He says, then who will kill me? He says, how can I capture him and kill him when he has not committed the crime yet? The Khalifa knows who will kill him, and he is the head of the state, and he would let him loose because he has not committed the crime yet. And just as an analogy, brothers and sisters, obviously there's no comparison here, but when Fir'aun heard that a boy is going to be born that will challenge his kingdom, what did he do? He ordered the killing of all the boys, such that some of the Mufassirin say 20,000 boys were killed because he heard a prophecy from certain Kohan, people who just look at the stars. That's Fir'aun, wal'ayadu billah. But look at Amir al-Mu'mineen, salamullah alayhi. He knows who his murderer is, but he lets him loose because he has not committed the crime yet. And then when he committed the crime, what does he say? He turns to Imam al-Hasan alayhi salam and says, feed him of what you are feeding me. Look after him. And if I am saved from this, I will take care of him. But if I'm not, he struck me once, you strike him once. That's it. Don't you, Bani Hashim, start going around killing people, arresting people unfairly because Ali ibn Abi Talib alayhi salam was killed. Subhanallah. Yusi biqatilih. He gives wasiyah about the one who killed him. This is Amir al-Mu'mineen salamullahi alayhi. Fassalamu alayhi yawma wulida wa yawma istushhida wa yawma yub'athu hayya. On such a night, he was in the house of Umm Kulthum alayhi salam. She says, my father that night could not sleep. He would come outside of his room. He looks at the stars and he says, hiya hiya wallahi al-layla allati wa'udtu biha. This is the night that my beloved Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi has promised me of. And then he would go back in. And he would continue doing his worship and ibadah, comes back again, looks at the stars. And he says, Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. She said, I looked at him, I said, Father, araka tan'a nafsak. I see that you are saying, Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. How come? he says, my daughter, إن أباك خاض الأهوال وقاتل الأبطال. Your father has fought against the bravest of the men and has been through the most difficult of challenges. Fear has never entered his heart like tonight. And that is because my time is nearing for me to meet my Lord. And then he goes into his room, worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Until late in the night, she said, I bring him some food. I brought him two plates. He looks at those and he says, Ya Bunayya, do you want Allah to prolong my stand before him? You're giving me two plates to eat? Take one. And he kept one, he ate a couple of bites, and he said, تَعْسًا لِمَنْ أَدْخَلَتْهُ بَطْنُهُ النَّارِ. He said, woe upon him who goes to Jahannam because of eating haram food. And then he gets up, gets ready to go to the masjid. The minute he leaves the room, there were a bunch of geese that were gifted to Al-Imam Al-Hasan or Imam Al-Husayn alayhi salam. The minute they see Amir al-Mu'mineen, they start shouting and calling. Then Umm Kulthum comes to keep them quiet. But then he says, leave them, ya Umm Kulthum. إِنَّهُنَّ صَوَائِحْ يَتْبَعْهُنَّ نَوَائِحْ وَفِي غَدَاتِ غَدٍ يَقَعُ الْقَضَاءُ الْمَحْتُومِ. They are really mourning me, ya Umm Kulthum. They know what's going to happen to me. He goes towards the door, opens the door, his belt becomes loose, so he starts tightening it, and he says, be prepared for death, ya Ali. أُشْدُدْ حَيَازِيمَكَ لِلْمَوْتِ فَإِنَّ الْمَوْتَ لَاقِيكَ ولا تأسى من الدهر إذا حل بنا ديكا كما أضحكك الدهر كذاك الدهر يبكيك. He then went to the masjid. He started calling الصلاة الصلاة يرحمكم الله. He enters the masjid. He finds Abdul Rahman ibn Muljim sleeping on his stomach. He says, oh man, the matter that you are plotting against me, the throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is shaking from it. He then goes to the mihrab and does the adhan. They say when he used to do the adhan, the walls of the masjid would really tremble as if they are doing adhan with him and doing tasbih with him. Then he stood to pray nafilatul fajr, salatul nafila, so that people start to gather. As he said, Allahu Akbar, he began reciting. Then he went into ruku' and the sujood. The minute he lifted his head from the sajda, the sword fell upon his head with a cry, Al-hukmu lillah la laka ya Ali. And he fell on the ground with his face covered in blood. And he said, I have won by the Lord of the Kaaba. This man has killed me. And the cry was heard in the skies. Jibreel alayhi salam said, تهدمت والله أركان الهدى قتل ابن عم المصطفى قتل الإمام المرتضى. The pillars of Islam have been torn down. The cousin of Rasulullah has been killed. Ali al-Murtada has been killed. The Muslims then gathered in the masjid crying, Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم وسيعلم الذين ظلموا أي منقلب ينقلبون والعاقبة للمتقين. Oh Allah, make us and our progeny until the day of judgment among the sincere Shia of Ali ibn Abi Talib alayhi salam. Oh Allah, grant us the ziyara of Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam in dunya soon, ya Allah. And grant us his shafa'a in dunya, in the qabr and in the akhirah. Oh Allah, fulfill all the needs of mu'mineen and mu'minat through the barakah of Amir al-Mu'mineen, salamullahi alayh. Give us the tawfiq to do the ibadah and worship you, ya Allah, in a way that you are pleased on these holy nights of Qadr and the last holy nights of this holy month. And free us from the hellfire, make us among the people of Jannah, and keep us among the ranks of Ali ibn Abi Talib, alayhi salam. Ya Allah, لقضاء الحوائج ولشفاء المرضى ولكشف هذه الغمة عن هذه الأمة ولتعجيل فرج مولانا صاحب العصر والزمان and for the أرواح of all المؤمنين المؤمنات رحم الله من قرأ السورة المباركة الفاتحة مع الصلوات. اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد وعجل فرجهم. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان.